First of all, I'd like to thank you all for coming. It's 7:21. You're 21 minutes late. Look, lately some of you have been asking for more constructive criticism. You're not too happy with my direct feedback approach. You can't handle me telling you that you suck? Quit sucking. You would rather have me wrap the crap about you between two nice pieces of sweetness. You're very consistent, then we stick in the negative. What you're most consistent about is being late, and then we wrap it up again with something very positive, which is, but at least you're consistent. You see how we did that? We took the hamburger patty shit and wrapped it with two buns of praise. So you're saying I never have nothing good to say. Okay, how about this? You hung drywall before the fucking electrician got here. But we're still going to the crazy horse tonight. You see how I did that? I told you you ain't worth a shit while still giving you hope for the future. Instead of telling Michael directly that he has no skill operating power tools, what I would say is, Michael, you look amazing holding a circular saw when it's not plugged in, when there's no blade. Now, operating it, you should never do. But holding it, you look amazing. Right, and what was I supposed to say when you cut your thumb off? Don't worry about it. You got another one. Alex, you are a champ at ordering tile. Unfortunately, because you don't read what you sign, you usually order the wrong tile. But once again, ordering tile, you're a boss. Bobby, I don't even know why I tell you what I want. When I say 7 and 7, you bring me back a Stroh's. What are you having, flashbacks of getting your dad a beer? Hold it together, Bobby. He's gonna be out in 6 months. Caleb, your thirst for knowledge is amazing. Your curiosity has no bounds. But here's the problem. All your questions are repetitive. All the answers have been given to you. It's like you're not listening. But once again, amazing thirst of knowledge, boundless curiosity. Rocco, listen for once. Beer before liquor makes you sicker. Liquor before beer, unless the Cocoa Puff is near. No, I never heard that one. Puff before weed prevents a nosebleed. What are you, making this shit up? Colin, all the customers talk about you. You're the most discussed employee that I have. However, none of them like you. They want me to fire you. They think you have a bad attitude. But again, most discussed, great conversation starter.
Sal, you're not great with customers. That's why I have them talk to you. How else are they gonna leave us alone?
John, you have a great ability to find hazardous materials on the job site. Now, you like to huff, puff, smoke, and snort those hazardous materials to the point where you can't function on the job. But once again, great ability to find hazardous materials.
You don't need to carry Jimmy to go get supplies. You're just going to Mayfield Lumber. You think I'd let you go on a Cocoa Puff run? Why, so you could come back with an empty bag?
Jose, you really know how to communicate emotion to a team. Even though most of your emotion is hate, rage, and anger, you really do know how to communicate emotion to a team.
You're a team player, Frankie. You're a ball hog. Nobody can play football or basketball with you. Why would I ask you to split the cash? Because you deserve more, Frankie.
Does anyone want to get back to regular criticism?
Yeah, me too.
I told you, you guys suck.
Damn, I miss the 80s.
Now who wants a 7 and 7? Every one of you are my kumbars. But every one of you are stunats. But every one of you are my kumbars.